The regular expressions, all right. So we might have definitely came across this term called as regular expressions, right? So generally, whenever we are searching for a text, so for example, if I open directdevops.blog and I open some classroom notes, right? So in this, I am interested in something called as environment. So I will try to search for something like environment, right? So we'll do this. Or you might have opened, okay, right? In here we will have find in files, right? So what is that you are searching for? I am searching for something called as AWS. Okay, so I'm searching for something called as AWS. So over here, are you seeing there is something called as use regular expressions? Even in text editors, we have this. So use regular expressions. So I'm interested in something where I have discussed something called as. Okay, so are you seeing it has matched some of the content? Okay, so I'm trying to search for the content. I'm trying to search for the content, and this is a very handy way of basically looking into the stuff. So what are basically these regular expressions and how were they developed, right? And what are the different cases where we try to basically use regular expressions, right? So one is for searching files, okay? The other one is basically for searching content, for searching different text and different files, right? Not only that, so people use this to search for specific text in log messages, right? So generally, I think in yesterday's class we have heard Mallikarjun trying to tell that they have loads of log files, and then when they want to search it, right, so they try to use regular expressions, right? So regular expressions are also referred as regexes. So they are also referred as regex. Okay, some people give the decency to it by trying to write it in this manner. Okay, so basically we use regular expressions to search something, but where did all of this start? Okay, so there is a math around it. Okay, whenever we are trying to use regular expressions internally, we are trying to use something else than what we think of. Okay, right. So what is that and how are we going to use it, right? So that is what I'll try to basically speak now. Okay, so the basic problem is, okay, the biggest lie about regexes is the way they are defined, right? Regular expressions are defined in a very, what do you call, not in the right manner. That is something which I want to clarify. So regexes are actually not what you think they are. Okay, so you might have seen that people define, okay, right, let me try to write about truth about regexes. Okay, so what is that we'll do? We'll try to define regexes. Okay, if I say definition of regex, most of the cases regular expression is defined as, okay, a regular expression is a right declarative. Just have patience with me, okay, because I have to type this. Declarative specification of describing the textual structure, okay, to match string, or to which the string should conform, whatever it is. Yeah, so this is what we'll generally look into. Yes, you might have come across some definition which looks like this, but the actual problem is regular expressions aren't declarative. Okay, so regular expressions are not definitely declarative, right? The problem with our definition is regular expressions are not declarative. Okay, am I clear on this? So to be very specific, a regular expression is imperative. Okay, so to be very specific, regular expression is, okay, a subroutine, right? Or you can call it as function or method, whatever it is. Okay, am I clear on this? So regular expression is basically, if I have to define it, it is a function. It is a function. Okay, and this function basically does something. This function basically does something. Okay, so what it does depends on what you type. So basically, if we are just starting to think of a regular expression as a subroutine, okay, in its own language, then most of the problems will come down. That is the first way of basically looking at it. Regular expressions are not declarative syntaxes, they are functions. Right, they are code. So if they are code, they will have all the, or will they have all the properties of the programming languages? Yeah, might not be all, but most of them. Now what our programming languages, or what grep or sed or awk will try to do, is they try to implement this regexes, or which is on its own languages, right? So inside Linux or inside Windows, we have all of this. Now if you want to understand regular expressions, right, very well, what is the language that we write inside regular expressions? That is an important question, right? In what language we write regular expressions? Is this not an important question? Right? So in what language do we write regular expressions? To be very specific, we don't write regular expressions in one particular language as such. Okay, but what we tend to do is we use something called as dialects. And the problem with regular expressions is they are consistently evolving, right? So in regular expressions, we would have basically dialects. And now let us try to see what are the different languages that are basically present. Okay, so how many of you don't know what a dialect is? I have said that most of the cases regex is defined as. Am I clear on this, sir? I have not defined it. I have written that in most of the cases regexes are defined as that which is not correct. That is what I was trying to basically. Okay, let me show you one question first. I got one question, I want to basically speak about that, right? So Shiva, am I clear on this? I have not defined regexes. I said that in most of the cases people do this, right? So, but the right way of looking out at regex is regular expression is not a declarative syntax. It is an imperative syntax. Imperative means you have to tell exactly what you have to basically do. right? So dialect in Telugu. Google is not giving that. I'm not sure. Google should give me this dialect in Hindi. Let me try this. Actually, Google has implemented the translator functionality. So that's the stuff which I'm amazed. Okay, let me try doing this. Okay. Fun in Telugu. Yeah. So fun is Saradaga. Then dialect. Okay. So for the people who are Telugu speaking, Mandalikam ante ento kachithanga telusu untadi. All right. Mandalikam ante teliyada? Wonderful, sir. I can't help you out. Okay. So yasa. That is the right word in Telugu, right? So dialect in Hindi is Boli. So for example, Hindi is not spoken in the same way across all the states in India, right? We have different dialects. And modulation is different. A modulation comes in dialogue delivery. That is Balakrishna and Chiranjeevi. No, not modulation, right? So it is the way you try to speak. Accent could be one of the way of looking at it. Yeah. Right, but accent is not really. In accent, you speak the same words, but for example, in dialects, you have small deviations also. For example, Telugu is spoken in two states, right, Andhra and Telangana. But to try to tell the same word, same, or to represent the same object, we might have a different term altogether. Okay, right. That's the whole stuff. So with slangs, what happens is some words get changed, right? So in the same way, okay, right? So if you belong to some other language, for example, if there are any Tamil speaking, I don't know what this is, right? You can try this Google search. It helps a lot. Okay, so right, you can try your mother tongue over here. Okay, right, sir. Anything, right? You can apply that. Okay. So if you are trying to look into regular expressions, in regular expressions, we have six major dialects. Okay. So this stuff takes, we have six major dialects. Okay, the first dialect is BRE, which is also right, represented as basic regular expressions. Okay, so this is what ED uses. Okay, so this is basic regular expressions. Right. Wow. Right. So I'm quite sure that we all know about POSIX, right? So for the people who don't know POSIX, right? POSIX stands for Post Portable Operating System Interface, right? So because there are many notations and we have different programming languages, so this is IEEE standard, which is basically helping in trying to facilitate application portability, right? So this is a POSIX standard, right? Or there is a POSIX standard around it, but I'll not speak a lot about it. But if you look out for tools, what tools use this? Right, so you are add, sed, and grep. They use this, and the second one is ERE. Okay, so ERE, this is regular expressions, extended regular expressions, right? So GNU, extended regular expressions. Right. Now, which tools use this? Right. When I said tools, I might be writing languages also there. Right. So, EGREP, extended grep. Okay. Okay. Global awk. Notepad plus plus. Okay. Right. And your TCL language. There is a language called as TCL. Let me write it as tools and languages. Tickle is what some of the people call this language as. Very popular. Was very popular. I'm calling it as was very popular because networking people have moved very much into Python now. Okay. So from there, Emacs. Right, so this is Emacs regular expressions. We have Emacs editors, right? So these were adopted by Emacs, right? So what are the tools that use it? Obviously, Emacs is a tool which uses it, right? Now we have Vim based regular expressions. So whenever you are using VI editor, okay, so in that we will try to use some search patterns. So what is the tool that uses? Vim. Okay, and then this is the most important one for developers, PCRE. Okay, or this is Perl 5 compatible regular expressions, right? So who uses it? Tools and languages. There is a huge list now, right? So obviously Perl uses it, right? .NET uses it, Apache Foundation uses it. Okay, C sharp uses it. Okay, Java uses it. JavaScript uses it. Right, PHP uses it. Okay, PowerShell uses it. So, right, PowerShell obviously will use this because PowerShell is based out of Python, based out of .NET. Right, R languages uses it, Ruby uses it. Okay, so I have basically came across, and if you are using Ultra Edit, okay, that tool also uses this. And then now this is PSIX, okay, which is Perl 6. Okay, so this stands for Perl compatible regular expressions, right? So Perl 6 regular expressions. Okay, so languages, which languages use this? As of now, there is a language called as Perl 6. Am I clear on this? So these are the popular ones, right? There are very many unpopular ones also. Am I clear on this, sir? So when we learn, it is like learning a language in six different accents or six different slangs, six different dialects, right? So there are some, there will be some similarities, there will be some dissimilarities, okay? But if you look into, we should basically focus on basic regular expression, extended regular expression, and PCRE. If you are a Vim editor, yeah, you would obviously use that already, right? But these three notations are something which will be really useful, which will be really useful, right? Okay. Now, they are not unique. They have some similarities which they have picked up from each other. Okay. But the first one to start was basic regular expression. So if you have to define some kind of a relation between these languages, okay, let me use a paint. Okay, so initially, okay, let me use a different font size. Where is font? Okay. Let me go with 16. Yeah, so initially when all of this started, we had basic regular expressions. Am I clear on this? Okay, we had basic regular expressions. Okay, now as the time progressed, right, these were extended, and who extended it? ERE, extended regular expressions. Am I clear on this? Extended regular expressions basically has extended it. Okay, or let me not write this. Okay, let me. Okay, extended regular expressions. Fine, sir. Now, from extended regular expressions, what has happened was, two different editors have started taking their own routes. Right? The first one is, okay, so we had VI editor or Vim editor. Okay, and then extended regular expressions from this Emacs had started doing its work. Okay, right. So basic regular, from basic regular expressions, extended regular expressions were created, and from this your Vim and Emacs were created, right? So Vim and Emacs will have some differences now in some of the expressions. Now then, what Perl or Perl compatible regular expressions has done is PCRE. Okay, it has taken goodies or good stuff from different languages over here. So let me try to, okay, stick it to this. Fine. Okay. Right, sir. So all of this have resulted into something called as PCRE. Okay, Perl compatible regular expression. So whatever regular expressions which you use in Java or Python or .NET for that matter has things which are picked up from different dialects. Okay, and now Perl 6 has came, and Perl 6 obviously, right? Perl 6 regular expressions, they have basically picked up from their ancestor, which is PCRE, right? And also Vim. So does it sound like a very strange relations? Yes, they are strange. All right. Now that's the reality of it, and I don't want to hide that reality around it. So when you are using regular expressions, depending on the where you are using your regular expressions, you might basically use a different dialect, right? In programming languages, mostly we use PCRE, okay? But when it comes to grep, sed, and awk, we might be using basic regular expressions and extended regular expressions, okay? Now that's where I said, okay, this is a useful discussion for all of us. Not only for you guys, but it is definitely useful for me as well, right? Okay. In September 19, let me create a new folder called as regular expressions. And inside this regular expressions, let me have this. Yes, I'm sure I want to move that. And in here, let me create a new folder called as images. Okay. Now I want to copy path of this and save this as regex1.png, right? So this is something I would basically call as these dialects, okay, have similarities, okay, and dissimilarities, right? So why should I write this again? Okay, and dissimilarities, okay? So there are relations, okay? Okay. Between dialects, okay? So preview, and let me use /images/regex1.md. All right, fine, sir. Yeah, so obviously, in which one is used by Jenkins? Jenkins is developed in Java and it will use Perl compatible regular expressions, right? So, but in Jenkins, if you are using regular commands or Linux commands, then you might be using the basic regular expression or extended regular expressions, right? It depends on where you are using it, okay? Right, okay, right, sir. So these languages have strange relationships between them, but that's okay, that's okay, that's something which we can digest, right? So there are some similarities and there are some dissimilarities, but okay, when we speak of regular expressions, right, I said that regular expressions are subroutines. Regular expressions are subroutines, right? So when I say subroutines, what will these subroutines do? What are its functionalities? What are its functionalities, right? So how are these regular expressions implemented? That is something which I am interested in. Okay, so how are regular expressions implemented? Okay, so this is the big question. But before I go over here, what I want to speak about is, right, let us go with a regex online editor. Okay, so there are something like online regular expressions. Okay, so are you seeing over here? So if you go with online regular expression editors, are you seeing this is used for PHP, PCRE, and all? So if you want, now you can type extended regular expressions, regex online. Am I clear on this? Right, sir? So if you go with regular expressions now, do we understand this dialect first? Sometimes you might try to pick a regular expression editor, and if in that editor it might be working, but if you copy into that regular expression into your programming language, it might not be working because dialect might be different. Am I clear on this, sir? I'll not go with anything which is insecure, but okay. So right, regular expressions. Now, okay, let me try to write some or take some word, Wikipedia, and in Wikipedia, let us search for computer. Okay, I will try to take some stream of text. Okay, right. So here I want to basically write a regular expression which is computer. Okay, what is it trying to tell? It doesn't have any matches. Why? But try this. Okay, I want to match computer and computers. I use some of this strange character called as dot. Okay, right, here I have messed up. Computer. All right, it's okay. Let me try to, I want lot of text. That's where I'm going to Wikipedia, right? Okay, let me go over here. Not this, we were using this, right? Yeah. Now, here I want to search some text. Okay, I want to basically search something called as memory. Directly type memory. But after memory, if I want to do something else. So how will this stuff work? Okay, am I clear on this? Right, so you might be writing some expressions memory dot, all right, or in some cases something which does this, and you might be using some dollar expressions over here, right? You might be using star over here, you might be using plus over here. Okay, that is all implementation details. But before we get into that implementation, okay, so how are these things implemented? This is where things get interesting, right? So let us try to get into that. How are regular expressions implemented? So if I want to speak about regular expressions, how are they implemented, I cannot start this discussion. I cannot start this discussions without basically speaking about state machines. All right. Without speaking about state machines. Right. So, but theoretically, at least theoretically, okay, right, at least theoretically, I have messed up. It is E over here. Right. Theoretically, okay, regular expressions are implemented on a finite state machines. Right. What is this finite state machine? Right. Okay. I'll just define this stuff. But practically, right. Okay, so practically almost all the languages, okay, implement regular expressions on stack based language. Don't worry about the terms over here, stack based machines. Okay, we are here to understand all of that. I'm just defining the term so that you will basically come across. Okay, so finite state machine, but helps us in understanding regular expressions wonderfully. So throughout this class I will be using, okay, but practically that's okay, all languages or whatever it is, practically they are implemented in but languages practically right implement regular expressions on a stack based machine, right? So but still, to understand regular expressions we will be using, okay, it is very difficult for me to write all of this, so I'm using the abbreviation over here, FSM. Okay, we'll be using finite state machine. Am I clear on this, sir? Okay, so in all the six dialects, okay, let us assume that you have, okay, let me go with Wikipedia, and in Wikipedia I want to search for cat. Okay, it's okay, I'm just going for cat over here. Yeah, it is easy to do this one. Wikipedia, and why is Wikipedia slow suddenly? Wikipedia cat. So let me search for cat in Wikipedia. Are you seeing this? Okay. I'll copy this text. Okay. All right. So to search cat, to search cat, okay, in all the six dialects, it is the same regular expression. So shall we start here? So, right, stacked means so don't try to get into that strange abbreviations. Just Google for stack of teacups. Okay. Now in this image, whatever you put first, you will be taking it last, or you will be taking it first. Naga, you try to tell me. So now what it would be, right? So don't get into that term, sir. This is a very easy way, right? So Q in front of store. Let me go into here. So I technically, whoever gets into the store first will basically get inside first, right? So in data structures, we basically represent this as first in, first out. Stack will represent it as last in, first out, or first in, last out. Okay, whatever it is. Yeah. Don't try to do this. This image is always a better representation. Yes, sir. Yeah. Good. Now, we were speaking about cat. Okay. So, to search for a word cat in the text sequence, right, in all six dialects mentioned above, the regex is cat. Okay, don't worry about that underscore, that is just to change it to an italic format. Okay, but what is this? How will this work? Okay, so the regular expression actually is this, to be very specific. Okay, right. Now, so if I want to represent this in a finite state machine, if I want to represent this cat in a finite state machine, it is very simple, right? So let me open paint. Okay, so if I want to represent this cat or ABC, whatever you call it, okay, if I want to represent in a finite state machine, it is very simply C A and T. Okay, so I'm just representing them in the format of transition graph. Okay, so just let us have a look out for it. So this is your start. Okay, and then here we will have a state, okay, which is match, which is match. Okay, so let me try to use different color notations for this. So start of the line, let me represent it and blue. Okay, and match obviously is green. Now, okay, let me use black for transitions. So we have start. From the start, we will go with state transitions. Okay, let me use this. Okay, right, fine, right. So from here we will have one more state transition. From here we have one more state transition, right? And from here why we have one more state transition, and this. Okay, technically this is how I represent a cat in a finite or in a transition graph. Okay, you should not call it as a finite state machine yet, but you can easily call it as, okay, okay, right, okay, right. So if we represent, okay, as a transition graph, okay, so let's represent cat in transition graph. Is it very difficult, sir? If I give a word, can't you draw an image which looks like this? Yeah, yeah, that image might slowly get complicated. That's a different story. Yeah, but is it very difficult to implement it? Yeah, are you finding this difficult? Okay, I give a regular expressions and then you have to implement. You would be trying to draw something like this. Okay, now this has very strange way of basically looking at it. Okay, this is a transitive representation, right? Now if I have to represent the same thing in the pseudocode, okay, or same thing in the coding language, this, right? So if the above regular expression, okay, so is represented by code, okay, all right, okay, so let me try to do this, right? What is that we would do? Okay, str, let us assume that str is the word where we have, or message, or the sentence to be matched. Okay, right, so index equals to 0, right, index less than, okay, length of string. Okay, I might be mixing multiple languages over here, so don't try to be very specific about a particular language over here, but right. Okay, so let us assume that this is what we have, and then I will try to tell that I am defining a variable called as match position, right, is equals to start position, or is equals to index. Am I clear on this? So initially we'll start with 0. Initially we'll start with 0. And then, okay, it is like I am writing a try block. And then I will try to tell that, okay, length of string, or length of message. Okay, here I will try to check that message of index is equals to A. Okay, or throw backtracking. Backtracking means go one level below. Okay, and then match underscore position plus plus. Okay, it might sound like a very complicated code. Let me try to show you what this is. Image is very, very simple representation of it. Now, okay, we will continue our discussion based out of these results, right? Here, C A T. Okay, so if all of this is done, then it will return true. Okay, so if this is not the case, then at the last of this, it will return false. Okay, so looking regular expression looks like a very complicated language, but if you try to represent it in a transitive graph, this is what it is. Now, how are you going to parse these graphs, right? How is the stuff that is going to work is something which we'll do in our next class, but I'll try to give you a hint of it. Okay, right. Generally, let us see this. Okay, this article. So I have started with the cat, right? Okay, so now you feed T into this. Is the starting letter T? So what is the starting letter which we have? Let me try to write that sentence. I'll just write simply the cat. Okay. Let me paste it over here. Notepad. Or I'll write it over here. So this is your input. What is the first letter which you are passing? T. Is T matching to C? Is T matching C? T and C, are they same? Yes or no, sir? Sir, you can reply with yes or no. Is T equal to C? Right? Definitely no. So then what happens is, okay, since T is not equivalent to C, okay, let me try to open Notepad, sir. Okay. D cat. So just look out for this cursor position. So initially we are looking out for T. Is T and C same? No. Then what happens? The cursor moves forward. Is H and C same? No. Then what happens is the cursor will move forward. Is E and C same? No. The cursor will move forward. Now, here we have a space. Is space equivalent to C? No. Now C, right? Since C has met, now what happens is now the state transition happens. So we have moved from here to here. And now let us come back to this notepad. Okay. Now A, is A also matching? Yes. Now it will go over here. Now it will go over to that. It will increase its index. Now T, is T also matching? Yes. Now it founds the match. It finds the match. Okay. So, but if I write something like the can, okay, the way it works is something different, right? So let me try to erase all of this. You understood this, right? Till THE space, we know what happens. Now our cursor is over here. Okay, C, good. This is true. A, yeah. But what has happened after that? We want T, but in reality, the word which we had is can. So what happens? It throws backtracking. Backtracking means this will go again to here. And then it will start searching from A. Okay, it will try to tell, okay, I have thrown a backtracking error. C is not the statement. Let me increment the word. Okay, so don't worry about this stuff. We will be understanding them better in our next class. I had a very little time to explain you this concept, but did you understand it? If you look at it as a code, it looks like a very complicated code. Okay, the simple cat. Okay, and this is the implementation of it. But fortunately, we don't need to write the code. We just need to write the expression. Okay, so to understand this, we will be looking at finite state machines. In that finite state machines, we will be looking at deterministic finite state machine and non-deterministic finite state machine. Okay, and then we will understand the regular expressions internals, right? Yes, sir. So is this class useful? Okay, I'm getting away straight from basics. Okay, I can directly show the regular expressions of how to write the regular expressions by looking at cheat sheets, but I don't believe in that approach, right? That is very difficult. Okay, right, sir. So we'll continue this discussion on next Monday. Thank you. Thanks for your time. I'll stop it at that.
Thanks for watching. For more videos, subscribe our channel and click on bell icon.